Morning guys, so I've just woken up. I'm heading off to find the Blue Sky Hotel, as we're off to the Blue City today, which is about 4 hours away. It's really strange because it's 7:30 in the morning and there is nobody on the streets. So I'm just going to concentrate on where I'm going. So I'm currently dripping with sweat after a mad dash through the Medina. Google Maps doesn't cope with the Medina very well. It gives you general directions, but it really doesn't know all of the back streets. So a couple of people helped me. They showed me where to go. If you stand still for 2 seconds here, somebody will appear and ask you where you want to go. And then they walk really fast. So I'm really grateful that they do that and that they help. But you've got to be willing to like follow the white rabbit through Wonderland. You've got to keep going. So I've got here, but I'm actually really kind of hot and salty. I'm now waiting for the bus. I'm at the Blue Sky Hotel in a cafe called the Cafe Cinema, or Cinema Cafe. Just getting some breakfast and then hopefully soon a bus will arrive. I'm not entirely confident, but let's see what happens. I got these to go in case the tour guide turned up, but I think I've got enough time to eat them now. They look amazing.
A guy did indeed turn up and drove me to the bus. We made it all of 5 minutes before we had to change to a larger bus because we were overbooked. But the bus was comfortable and air-conditioned, and we were soon on our way out of the Medina. A Medina is the old walled city of a North African town. These are the walls of Fez Medina. Fez has expanded beyond those walls, but the modern parts are pretty nondescript, like the modern high streets of any city. The tangle of ancient streets and pretty shops all lie inside the walls. We had a brief pit stop to look at Dam Sidi Chahed, which is an artificial lake built in 1996. It can hold 30 million gallons of water for the local town and agricultural needs. There are also a lot of fossils found here. I really like bus journeys, and I was excited to see what Morocco looked like. I was surprised just how arid it is. Fez is almost 300 miles from the start of the Sahara, but it feels as though the desert is creeping north. We passed a lot of prickly pear cacti dying from cochineal, like the ones in southern Spain. Had another quick stop to get ice cream. I wish I could have thrown myself in that pool. The further north we went, the more greenery we started to see. Then we caught our first glimpse of Chefchaouen. Forgive my terrible pronunciation in this video. It's Chefchaouen, but to be fair, there's a lot of vowels in there.
So we've just arrived in Chefchaouen, and it's called the Blue City. So we're heading down there. From this distance, there are a few blue houses, but it doesn't look entirely blue. So we'll go and see how blue it is.
This is the entrance to the Medina, We have 4 hours to look around. There's really no instructions on where to go. You just have to follow your feet.
Medina, and I can confirm it is extremely blue. Instead of going to sort of Fez, where you go down to go into the Medina, here you go up towards the mosque.
Hello Marianne, how are you? You're welcome. My name is Ibrahim, geologue man, a crazy man stones, but positive. Positive crazy man, yes. This actually is one kind for ammonite snails. I found this in 9 meter ground, deep by hand. Found this between Middle Atlas and the Atlas Mountains. Then carted with diamond disc. Then you have this quality. Normally it was slain snail long time ago, between 70 and 210 million years ago. Like what you say here is you have sandrosa, shark shoes, trilobites. It's the mostly very old fossils we have in the world. It's trilobites in the world, not just in Morocco. The trilobites, it's mostly very old one, between 230 and 530 million of years ago. This kind for stones, for fossils, the name of it Septarian. I found it in Morocco too also. I found it like that, then cut it with diamond disc. Quartz diode, amethyst, vanadium, the red one, we find it in the mines, 25 meter ground, deep by hand. This coral, agate, pyrite, the red one, vanadium, that one, it's pyrite. False gold. We have also the blue one, azurite malachite, is oxidation of copper. We find it also in the mines.
How long have you been doing this?
Well, normally 17 years ago, this is my job. And my job, I'm learning by doing my job. Very hard job, but lovely things. When I found something beautiful, I feel more happy than. Anytime you want to come to Morocco and you want to look to try to find some, I'm here. I'm not crazy. I'm crazy positive. You're welcome.
wandering around for a bit longer, I decided to go in search of lunch.
It's a cheeky bugger. It's cheeky.
There's a Spanish mosque in Chefchaouen, which is supposed to be really pretty, but it was an extremely hot day in the mid-30s, and I was starting to get a bit crispy. I decided to go see if I could rock the Kasbah instead. A Kasbah is an ancient fortification. This one also had a small museum inside. There are a lot of areas that were closed off and no information in English, but it offered an insight into how traditional woodwork and tiles were made. This reminded me of the ceiling in my Airbnb. Decided to climb to the top of the tower to look at the view.
Top of the Kasbah Tower in Chefchaouen, and it's quite a view. Spoiler alert, the blue city is not entirely blue. It is, I'd say it's about, I don't know, at least about 40% blue, and some of the back streets are entirely blue. It's really pretty. It's a nice place to be. It feels a bit less hectic than Fez Medina, I guess because it's smaller than Fez Medina. You do still get a lot of approaches to buy things, to go to restaurants, but as with everywhere, it's pretty, you know, it's pretty chilled out. So I'm just enjoying looking around. I've come into the Casbah. A few of the other YouTube reviewers and TripAdvisor reviewers said that they didn't pay to come in here because it is €6. Well, it's 60 Moroccan money. I'm still getting the hang of this. 60 Moroccan money, which is about €5, about £4 at the moment. Which is, I've got to say, it's not the best value. If you think about somewhere like the castle at Denia, which was only about €3 to go in, and they have the museum and the cafe, and you can walk around this big castle. The Casbah is pretty small. It's got a tiny museum with a couple of small displays of crafts and arts and crafts. But other than that, there isn't that much in here. But I'm really glad that I came up here for the view.